So here's a case study. I worked with a 22-year-old male, and we worked with him in the clinic. He had recurrent concussion syndrome. He was an aspiring MMA fighter, really great kid, but he got hit in the head a few times too many. And one of the big problems is that not only did he get hit once, he got back in the gym and got hit again. He got hit pretty close to the first head trauma. I think it was like 7 days later that he got another head trauma. There's a remarkably high likelihood of dying on that second head trauma when it occurs within a brief period of time. The person basically can drop dead, or they go to sleep that night and they don't wake up. So it's a really serious issue. And it was interesting, when he did any type of hard glycolytic work, like boxing, kickboxing, wrestling, CrossFit type activity, he would go into basically a syncope type state. Like his eyes would track kind of randomly. He couldn't talk. And to me, from the outside looking at him, it looked a lot like a hypoglycemic event. I've seen this in the hospital before, where somebody will hit a hypoglycemic ebb and you give them some sort of glucose solution or some fruit and they perk right back up. And that's what we did with him, and it would perk him up immediately. And even though that's helpful in the moment, that's not really addressing the problem.